Hey, what's up, guys? We are only one subscriber away from 150 subscribers, which is super cool. And I decided that we will have a 150 build drop party after we hit 150 subscribers. And I'm giving away 20 Death Touch Arts in buy build this video. So please comment your name below and like this video. And as always, guys, I will be announcing the winner at the end of this video. So everyone is wondering, how often does QBD actually drop the Real Life Z? Well, stay tuned and I will reveal that at the end of this video. But first, guys, we are debating about whether or not the Infinity Gauntlet needs to be updated. Some people are saying that as bosses are added, the Infinity Gauntlet keeps getting harder and harder. So at the moment, we have more than 40 bosses, guys, and every time we add a boss to the game, the Infinity Gauntlet takes more time for newer players. So the question is this fair for new players? Well, some people who had the Infinity Gauntlet said they didn't want to do the extra bosses to keep using the gauntlet. So let's say that I had to do 100 extra boss kills to be able to use the gauntlet again. Well, guys, that's not that many, but what if you made me do 500 extra boss kills to use the gauntlet again? Well, actually, 500 boss kills is quite a few boss kills, guys. I think that the majority of people would get mad if we made them kill the newer bosses 100 times just to keep wearing the Infinity Gauntlet. But let me know what you guys think. Do you guys think that people with the Infinity Gauntlet have to kill new bosses 100 times to satisfy the boss kill requirement? So in RuneScape, we know that they make people do new quests so they can continue to wear the quest cape. So do you guys think that if they get the item once, they should always have it? Or do you guys think that they always have to meet the same requirements that everyone else has to meet? It would be fair if everyone had the same boss kills, but if they get the item once, should they have the item for the rest of eternity? So the thing is, guys, we keep adding new bosses so that they can drop new items and so YouTubers can show off our cool new boss mechanics. So we're basically going to continue making new bosses so the number of bosses we have could increase to 50 in the next 6 months or even 60 in the next year. So let's say if someone kills 40 bosses now for the gauntlet, but in 1 year they have to kill 60 bosses. Do you guys think that that's okay? I mean, I guess it's 50% more boss kills, but are boss kills even the hardest part of Infinity Gauntlet, guys? Don't you guys think that the 1k kill streak is actually harder than the boss kills? All right, so we're going to get into the news, guys. Unfortunately, we lost an administrator 789. He made some of the best guides on our forums, and I think that he doesn't get enough credit for it. But let's talk about all the recent players we've lost. So for our last video, we lost Ares, and a few videos before that, we lost some other administrators. But that's okay, since those other administrators were duplicating. But anyways, guys, let's think positively. I still get compliments that our RSPS is the most fun that they've ever had, so I'm trying my best to add content every single day that makes this game more fun. And one problem we have at the moment is that we don't have enough guides for money making, I think. So I'm gonna make a money making guide, and also I think that we also need an armor progression guide as well. So some people are making suggestions in friends chat, which sometimes can be annoying. So if you guys phrase the suggestion in a bad way, it will make it look like a complaint and not a suggestion. So if you have a suggestion, there needs to be a system where you report the suggestion directly to a developer. So if you have suggestions, please put it in private chat or DM. Or otherwise, if you do have to say it in friends chat, please don't phrase it like a complaint or anything. Otherwise, people could get mad. All right, so anyways, guys, let's take a look at the drops for QBD. Alright guys, so as you can see, we're going to simulate Queen Black Dragon kills 1,000 times. So we're going to do this probably 3 times just to simulate how many rings of life we get. Alright, so oh my god, guys, look at this. We actually got 3 Ring of Life Z from this 1,000 kills, which is absolutely insane. So some people don't actually get that many Ring of Life Z, so that's pretty good. That's only like 1 in 300. And this is supposedly a super accurate drop simulator, guys. So this is what you can expect to get. 3 Ring of Life Z's and 3 Shadow Dives. And then, you know, this Royal Crossbow is super common. I bet you guys could get that in 50 QBD kills, all the parts for that probably. 50 to 100 QBD kills. But anyways, guys, let's do it again. Oh my god, guys, we actually got 4 Ring of Life Z's from this one. And, oh, look at that. We also got 4 Shadow Dives. All right, so, yeah, basically, that's amazing, guys. Oh, that's not good, guys. We only got 2 Ring of Life Z's and 2 Shadow Dives, which... it's kind of weird we keep getting the same number of Ring of Life Z's as Shadow Dives, but I'm pretty sure that Shadow Dive might actually be more common than Ring of Life Z. I'm not 100% sure. I feel like, okay, so far we've seen it drop. How many did we see it drop the first time, guys? Did we see it drop 3, and then we saw it drop 4, and then we saw it drop 2? So the average would be like 3, I think, right, guys? All right, so you guys are probably wondering who won last video's giveaway. It's actually Deeds, so congratulations to Deeds. All right, so once again, like and comment this video for a chance to win 20 Death Touch Arts and 5 billion. All right, guys, peace out.